Hello everyone, this is Jean-Michaël. In this third video of our series on multimedia APIs, I am going to talk about Gstreamer. Gstreamer is the leading API under Linux systems for multimedia video audio playback. It is also available under Windows, macOS, and also is used in a wealth of embedded systems. For instance, if you want to playback video on a Raspberry Pi, it will most likely use Gstreamer at some point. So, what does make it good? First, we must note that it is a LGPL-based API, so you can use it in proprietary software. The particularity of Gstreamer is that it is built around a Dataflow API. What is Dataflow API? It is an API where you have a set of nodes that you compose, kinda like the Unix philosophy of the olden days. And each of these nodes will perform one task, for instance, fetching video from the internet, applying a video filter, playing back to ALSA or Pulse Audio or whatever output sync you have. And as a user, your responsibility is to combine all these nodes into something that plays back your media and applies whatever filter you want. Note that Gstreamer provides a cute example which hides all of this behind a very simple multimedia API, multimedia player API, where you just have to call play, stop, that kind of easy media player thing. So first, let's look at some Dataflow examples. The most simple, the starting point is the gst launch command. And nodes, you pass a list of nodes separated with a exclamation mark. The exclamation mark indicates that the output of this goes into the input of this. This example simply plays back a test video. Now, let's do something more interesting. Instead of playing back through the default API, which is in this case Xvideo under Linux systems, we will go through OpenGL. So here I use the GL upload to send my video data as a GPU texture buffer and play back through a GL shader pipeline. So these are very simple examples, but now we can start adding more interesting stuff in our pipeline, for instance, GL-based effects. Let's look at the first one, Glfx Heat, which simply applies a kind of heat map. And as you can see, the colors changed. I hope you could see that. But if not, worry not, we have a wealth of other effects. So to check out the effects, we have this gst inspect command, which lists all the things, all the available nodes. So as you can see, there are quite a lot of those in my machine. So we can just grab for OpenGL, and here we have all the GL-based effects. So let's look, for instance, at the fisheye effect. In my pipeline, I will just replace heat by fisheye, and hopefully everyone should be able to see this. So to get more acquainted with Gstreamer, the documentation is extremely useful. Let's look a bit at it. For instance, for this effect, we have all the input and output informations, all the properties that can be applied to the effects, and also, it is quite useful to check the man pages if you're on the Linux, because they have very nice examples of all the possible pipelines. And of course, then your imagination is the limit. But for instance, you have pipelines to play back movies, that kind of thing, stream from the internet or stream to the internet. So let's look at a more complex pipeline, one which will play back a video. So here I have the file source which node which reads a file. It is decoded, and then we branch because we have both the audio and the video pipeline, and we only have text here to specify our pipeline. So the way to do that is to give a name to one node, and then at some point we will branch again and go back to that node. First, we do our video convert, which decodes video and play it back to auto video sync. And then we do the same for the audio part of the media file. And if you play that, it will play our video. Now, let's look at the cute bindings. So there is this GST example repository, which comes with a wealth of examples for using Gstreamer with GTK, Qt, and all kinds of other systems. The Qt bindings is very nice as it provides a QML example, which could easily be retrofitted into Qt widgets. But let's look at it. It gives us a player item and a GST GL video item, which are very simple objects, which follow, again, the kind of API that Qt Multimedia provides with the video output and video player separation. And these objects wrap all the low-level behavior to make sure that you just have to pass an URL up to a file to play it back and that things will work automatically. But it's interesting to go and check the actual, for instance, player item, which comes from QGST player, and look at all the available properties, so duration, position, volume. It's the third video, we already know all that. All the video APIs kind of look the same because we always want to do the same thing. And the implementation directly uses the C API of Gstreamer, so there is not a lot of things which are hidden, and it will be relatively easy to start using introducing custom nodes in our data processing here or write more complex applications using that. Thanks for watching. The next video will be about Ffmpeg, which is the last and one of the most important video APIs. Ffmpeg does much less than the other things, but it is used everywhere. For instance, VLC, MPV use Ffmpeg. Gstreamer can optionally use Ffmpeg. And it is used by software such as Google Chrome.